This conference will now be recorded.
All right, so happy Monday. Today is Monday, March 16th. And as always, everything that we're going to be talking about today is for educational purposes only, and nothing is intended as any type of investment advice. All right, so we can see another substantial drop today. And just taking a look right now, we're at, you know, already up over 10% down in the SPY right now. We are starting to still see selling coming at those bottoms. So just one thing to just keep in mind is that the market might get halted as soon as we open up. So just something to think about. It's kind of interesting too, because I'm not seeing a ton of trading out there. A lot of things have taken some pretty big gap downs, but just not really a ton of trading going on. And I think it might have a lot to do with the fact that, you know, we're down almost 11% already. It's 13%, right? If we go to 13%, then they halt the entire day, I believe. So obviously, I really hope that doesn't happen. And hopefully, we'll start to see some plunge protection come back in and get this thing back up a little bit, so the moment the market opens, we'll be fine. But a few things going on out there. So first thing is PDD. Love the show of hand that we've seen so far. Coming into the morning, which is very weird. But if you look right here, 4:02 a.m., okay, that is a very, very, it's kind of odd to be completely honest with you. But 32 going into a show of hand. And then as we got closer to 9 o'clock, we can see the 31. So we really, all the bigger prints that we've seen in here, I'll meet you at the standard. it's 20% for the entire day. 13. Okay. So 13 next hole, 20% for the entire day. All right. So we probably shouldn't have to worry about that. I don't see it going to 20%. That would, you know, that'd be a substantial jump. But overall, so I really love, this is my favorite stock that I see this morning. It's not really doing too much trading. It's only got 161,000 shares, but like I said, all bigger selling, everything that we've seen coming into this morning so far. So we're going to be expecting a pretty nice pull up coming from 31. And then obviously going to be looking for a trigger back down to then satisfy the prints, 30 being our first price target, just because we're going to get more information there. And then that should tell us a lot about whether or not we're going to have the chance first to get to 2750 and then obviously 25 being a, you know, bigger psychological number. Next thing, looking at is CCL. And this is another one. This is actually pretty smooth. It's just the problem is I haven't seen a lot of actual trading that's going on. Early this morning at 1480, it looks like we're pulling up from selling, but then we had some riders that came into that 15 level. And then it kind of, you know, it's just, it's got all the variables. It's got great volume, 1.2 million shares coming in. And we know that this thing is going to have a bigger than usual range, on average $1.54. You can see even on Friday, and Friday was pretty slow, we had $3.45. So absolutely, you know, a very smooth looking stock. It just hasn't given that great show of hand yet. And then obviously 15. So what I really would have liked to see is a lot better selling that came into 15, because then knowing that pull up over 15, 15 being such a hard level to hold, makes it for a very high percentage trade back towards that downside. But we just kind of have to wait for that show of hand to come in. We still are seeing selling, like I said, and then holding 15 is not going to be an easy thing for it. Next thing looking at is OPGN. Davis, does anyone know the speaking schedule for today, this week? I do not. So OPGN, this is another one where, you know, it's not great, because once again, you know, coming up this morning, there just wasn't a ton of actual trading that was coming into it. And I really, these cheaper stocks, I love to see that buying at highs, because when they start buying in these consolidations to then just kind of jump it and it doesn't have anything to go towards, the percentages go lower. So not really anything that great that's up near those highs. Obviously, you know, last week, OPGN, we've seen some good buying up above, but as of this morning, just not really anything there. So I'm going to need to see a lot more. You know, the prints that we see at 350 so far, I mean, 370 is not terrible, but at the same time, it's not really enough for such a cheaper stock. So I'm going to be watching for them, what they're actually building within this consolidation, looking for what the prints are going to be doing from there. So we'll take it from there, but we just need to see more buying within this consolidation. Then side list, HTBX. So HTBX, make sure that it fits your game plan, because this is not, you know, one of those stocks that's, you know, real. I mean, technically it could move back up to one, because we did see a whole bunch of buying about a week ago that came up towards that one level. So technically, I mean, you're talking about a 50, you know, 60 cent stock that does have the actual ability to run up another 40. So Overall, you know, it's on the side list just because of the fact, once again, there's just not a ton that came into here that I really, you know, kind of fell in love with. It's just been a little bit more sporadic than I would like to see. There's definitely new buying that's coming into it, but not anything that really, really stands out. And then obviously, I was not a big fan of the selling that came in. I'm around that 63 level, around those highs. It looks like someone took a lot of their position off this morning coming into there. But knowing it's 50 cents and how high the volume is, 1.9 million shares already, it takes a lot. So the positions in here are going to be absolutely huge. And other than that, guys, I don't have, I mean, obviously, you know, we're going to keep an eye on INO. We're going to be looking at CODX. You know, AIM, I'm still kind of interested in looking at AAL, the airlines, any other cruise type, you know, type stocks. But at the same time, there's just not really a lot out there that's jumping out, that's saying, okay, this is going to be a great trade once the morning comes in, because, you know, I've got a lot of stuff down, like I said, but just not a ton of real trading that's coming in yet. So we'll have to take it from there. Okay. Now, anything else out there that I missed? I know it's a short list, but so ZM is, I mean, at this point, it's really just an everyday stock. I mean, it's a great trading stock. Most of what we've seen this morning has all been on first in the smaller time in sales. So not really any great show of hand that came into this yet. But, you know, see, the thing is that without the prints over 1,000, we really don't have that show of hand in there yet. But, you know, overall, I mean, they're definitely, you know, don't get me wrong, it's a lot of volume, but 91,000 shares, this isn't going to do it for us. We want to see something, you know, the big nice burst that comes out. 103 is not bad at all. You know, it's only 2,000 shares, but that's a big deal compared to, you know, relative to what we actually are seeing going on out there. I'll throw it on our list, but I'm just going to tell you something. I have it on like my on my 9Buy screen, and it's an everyday stock for me now. I look at it to trade every single day because it really is a smooth trading stock. Just like I said, don't really have that great show of hand yet. All right, guys, so let's get ready for our morning. Remember, you know, right now we have a kind of a smaller list, so there is going to be a lot of scanning coming, but there's no reason to rush anything. We're going to end up seeing high probability trades coming out, and, you know, just have to be patient. You know, like I say, you know, we always say it only takes that one. So let's make sure we're focusing on what our habits are and what's going to increase our trading the most today. All right, guys. So remember, Traders Exchange tomorrow, classes begin. Classes are going to be on anticipation. So anybody out there that has any questions or anything like that, feel free to DM myself and or Dave. And other than that, guys, I will talk to everyone in the chat. Happy trading.